Lockheed Martin's, Sikorsky, and Boeing's DEFIANT X, for U.S. Army's future long-range assault aircraft competition. Lockheed Martin Company and Boeing announced 6 new members of Team DEFIANT. These supplier teammates will join the team to support DEFIANT X, the advanced helicopter for the U.S. Army's future long-range assault aircraft competition. These companies were selected based on exceptional performance and experience supporting the U.S. Army's venerable Black Hawks, Apaches, and Chinooks. The team's exceptional performance will continue to ensure efficiency and affordability throughout DEFIANT X's life cycle, by embracing the Army's modular open systems approach requirements and continuing to embrace advanced manufacturing techniques already used to design and manufacture the Army's current fleet. The team previously announced that Honeywell will provide its new HTS 7500 turboshaft engine to power DEFIANT X. DEFIANT X is the right aircraft, made by the right team, for the Army's future long-range assault aircraft mission, said Mark Cherry, Vice President and General Manager of Boeing Vertical Lift. Leveraging many existing supplier relationships, we've put together the best industry team to deliver a purpose-built, low-risk and cost-effective next-generation aircraft that can operate across multiple theaters, well into the future. Lieutenant General, retired, Ben Hodges has pointed out the ability to mass combat power, infantry and equipment, directly onto the objective, many times in very tight places is the key tenet of an air assault operation, while remarking that one of the challenges I had in Afghanistan was getting soldiers and equipment across mountain ranges or into landing zones at high altitude and hot temperatures. This tracks with my 10 years of experience as a combat helicopter pilot in Afghanistan and as a developmental test pilot. Range and speed, though important, are not the most important criteria. What counts much more is the ability to land on the objective and mass combat power incredibly quickly, including supporting equipment, fires, and vehicles, and survive while you do it. Landing troops in waves because your assets can't mass them safely in the landing zone is a recipe for mission failure. One of the aircraft under consideration for future long-range assault aircraft, DEFIANT X, completed the confined area landings mission profile, including a 247-knot level ingress, rapid, level deceleration, and a vertical landing in an H-60-sized landing zone. Team DEFIANT is building a strong nationwide supply chain to provide the Army a transformational aircraft, said Paul Lemo, president of Sikorsky. This team and its proven experience will ensure that DEFIANT X is a low-risk, reliable and survivable aircraft for our soldiers and the Army's long-range assault mission. Also this week, the Lockheed Martin Sikorsky-Boeing SB-1 DEFIANT helicopter arrived in Nashville to give U.S. Army aviators a first-hand look at this impressive aircraft at the Army Aviation Association of America's annual summit. Army aviators at the summit will be able to see how Team DEFIANT is revolutionizing future vertical lift, one of the Army's top modernization priorities, with a focus on transforming the future long-range assault aircraft program's capabilities, production and sustainment resulting in lower life cycle costs. The result is DEFIANT X, a complete weapons system that builds on the handling qualities and capabilities proven by the team's technology demonstrator, SB-1 DEFIANT. The contract award for the U.S. Army's future long-range assault aircraft is expected this year. Assault platform in the world, and DEFIANT X will bring the next level of capability that the future long-range assault aircraft requires. On the choice of future long-range assault aircraft itself, the manufacturer must have a portfolio of military projects to sustain operations without depending on the future long-range assault aircraft program. It should also have a mature digital design, production, and sustainment capability with reach back across all services. Finally, Army should go with whichever option grants the edge on life cycle costs, training, and infrastructure requirements. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.